Francis Wolff was a Berlin photographer who made it on the last boat in November 1939 from Berlin to New York before the Nazis closed Germany off. Jazz was his love, photography was his trade, and with Alfred Lion he started Blue Note Records. Even though his duties lay elsewhere, at every single recording session for the next 30 years, he brought his Rolleiflex and visually documented an extraordinary archive that matches one of the most important musical archives in American music. Blue Note was started in 1939 by two German Jewish refugees, and what it really was an alternative music label. When only the majors were recording commercial swing bands, these two jazz fans decided to do something completely different, and they set a tone that became the standard for modern jazz with Art Blakey and Horace Silver, Lou Donaldson and Hank Mobley and Lee Morgan. And its influence ripples today through hip-hop, through contemporary jazz, and through modern jazz. From 1939 till about 1968, Francis Wolff photographed every Blue Note session, and for most of those years, the label recorded almost once a week. The amassed archive of 20,000 incredible images has been painstakingly culled down to about 45 images, and they represent the first public exhibition of Francis Wolff's photographs. We titled this exhibition No Room for Squares, and we mean it. A lot of Blue Note's covers were inventively designed by Reed Miles, and an integral component in each cover was the photographs by Francis Wolff, which Reed Miles artfully cropped. And one thing that we'll be showing at this exhibition is the full photograph of a lot of cropped images from iconic Blue Note covers, including Hank Mobley's No Room for Squares. One thing that set Blue Note apart from other labels was that they had rehearsals, they prepared, and every album was immaculately produced. They were all recorded in the living room of Rudy Van Gelder's parents. Rudy was an extraordinary Wunderkind recording engineer who learned his craft mostly by making it up himself, and he defined the sound of modern jazz. Among the masterpieces that took place in that living room were John Coltrane's Blue Train. One of the most exquisite albums from start to finish, it remains one of the greatest Coltrane albums ever recorded. Francis Wolff was also on his toes that day because he took some of the most magnificent and haunting images of John Coltrane, Lee Morgan, and Curtis Fuller. All these sessions were recorded in Rudy Van Gelder's living room. And you can look at a shot of Miles Davis in the process of recording a record, and there in the background is Rudy's parents' television. Among the artists that Blue Note recorded, and which will be represented in this Francis Wolff exhibition, are Dexter Gordon, Eric Dolphy, Ornette Coleman, Lee Morgan, Art Blakey, Thelonious Monk, Jimmy Smith, Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter, and many more.